Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. My name is Shashank Parmar and in this today's video we will be discussing about the date rape drugs. So basically, what is a date rape drug? Date rape drugs are substances that are sometimes used to facilitate sexual assault. When used in these ways, these drugs are often given to the victim without their knowledge. Sedatives, drugs that cause memory loss are the most frequently used drugs for this purpose. They are often slipped into the alcoholic drinks which can exacerbate their effect. These date rape drugs are often odorless, tasteless, and making them difficult to detect. This type of drugs can make people weak, confused, or even unconscious. As a result, these people are often unable to defend themselves against an attack. In some instances, they might not even know that an attack took place. Anyone can be the victim of an attack facilitated by a date rape drug. Now, let's see the common types of date rape drugs. First of all, GHB, which is gamma hydroxybutyric acid. This is a depressant that has many nicknames like Easy Lay, Georgia Homeboy, Liquid X, Liquid Ecstasy, Liquid E, and many more. Doctors sometimes prescribe it to treat a sleep disorder called narcolepsy. GHB is usually liquid that can be mixed with other liquids. It also comes as a powder, and both of them are tasteless and odorless. Its effects: it can make you sleepy, forgetful, or weak. It can also cause seizures, slow heartbeat, slow breathing, and a coma. The effect starts within 15 to 30 minutes and lasts up to 3 to 6 hours. Now let's talk about rohypnol, which is also known as flunitrazepam. It is a strong benzodiazepine, which is a class of tranquilizers known as a Mexican Valium, Circles, Rufis, La Roca, and many more names. It's not available legally in the United States. In other countries, doctors sometimes use it as anesthesia before the surgery. Its effects: it relaxes you, and in the high doses, it can cause trouble controlling your muscles, amnesia, loss of inhibitions, and the loss of consciousness. Its effects usually starts within 30 minutes and peak about 2 hours after you take it. As little as 1 milligram can affect you for 8 to 12 hours. Now, ketamine. This is a dissociative drug that makes you feel detached from reality. Its nicknames include Special K, Vitamin K, and Ket Valium. Doctors and veterinarians use it as anesthesia. Researchers are also studying it in people who have severe depressions. It is a clear liquid or an off-white powder that's often injected. You can't smell or taste it. It might make you hallucinate or feel woozy. It can also cause an upset stomach, vomiting, high blood pressure, changes in your heart rate, seizures, or a coma. It usually takes effects within 30 minutes and lasts an hour or two, but you could be affected for a day or more. Now, alcohol. Many attackers use one of those three drugs along with alcohol. It can boost the medicine's effect, but alcohol by itself can also keep someone from defending themselves, knowing what's happening to them, or remembering it later. It may make you relaxed, chatty, and confident. As you drink more, your emotions become unstable and you lose control of your body. Drinking too much can put you in a coma. Alcohol usually enters your brain within a few minutes. Now, we will talk about how to avoid date rape drugs. First of all, pour your own drinks. Avoid open containers that could be spiked, like punch bowls. Don't accept drinks from other people. Keep control of your drinks at all the times. Carry it yourself, even if you have to take it to the bathroom with you. Don't drink anything that tastes strange. Stick with your friends and ask them for help if you start to feel odd. Now, for the detection purpose, several devices have been developed to detect date rape drugs. First of all, straw sensor. One of the two best scientists, that is Fernando Petalowski and Michael Lofe of Tel Aviv University School of Chemistry, say they have developed a sensor that can tell you in a real time whether your drink has been spiked with common date rape drugs. This sensor, which looks like a straw, or we can say a swizzle stick, works like sucking up a small sample of the drink and mixing it with a testing solution that causes the stick to change color if the drugs are present. A red light also goes on so it can be used in the dark. The drug itself is reacting with this chemical formulation and the previously clear formula becomes dirty. And when the light shines, you can detect it. Lofe told AFP recently that you don't have to do anything but dip it in your drink. So far, the sensor has been 100% accurate in test for GHB and ketamine, the researchers say. They are also trying to get it work with Rohypnol, another common date rape drug. All these are colorless, odorless, and tasteless drugs. The sensor's chemical formula is inexpensive to produce and non-toxic, and the device could be commercially available within a year and a half. The scientists are looking for investors to help them in market. They may change the way the danger is communicated to the drinker. For instance, the sensor could send a text to the user's phone to warn discreetly about the presence of a drug. Then comes the SIP chip. SIP chip is a small device and used in detection of drug in a drink. It is very, very easy to use this drug. First of all, peel back the protective foil, place a drop of your drink on the sample port, and then look for the one line or the two. Here, one line means your drink is spiked, so discard it. And when the two lines are present, then it is clear and you can drink it. Here you can see the three simple steps of a SIP chip. Now, when this is used properly, it detects most of the common date rape drugs, including Rufis, Xanax, Valium, Worst, Cerex, and Restoril. Now, the bracelet. The bracelet, which is already available at the German healthcare shop DM Grocery Market, is white and resembles the ribbon used to enter the many clubs. It has two green circles that turn blue if the wearer applies some of the drink and the result is positive for the drugs. The bracelet also aims to deter potential offenders when they see someone wearing it, as well as serving as a reminder to the wearer to be mindful of the crime. Now, what are the methods to use this bracelet? First of all, stick a drink check wristband around your wrist when you go out. Then, dab a small amount of the liquid from your drink onto one of the two test fields. Wait for 2 minutes. If the test field turns blue, then it means your drink has been spiked. Tear off your wristband at the end of the night. Thank you so much for watching our video. I hope you liked it. And if you are new to the channel, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And you can also visit our website www.thesci-hub.in for more amazing content. Thank you so much.